Hey guys, today I want to talk about mixing. And I know this is a very big subject, but I just want to give you a few tips for a rough introduction. And I want you to be on the right path so you have an easy start, right? So some simple tips and tricks to get things going. To start, of course, we need a track, and I got something prepared for you. And this is a small draft I created some weeks ago. Let's hear it first. And of course, some instruments are too quiet. The overall mix down is too quiet. And that's why we are here, to learn how we mix down this track, okay? The first thing we need to do is to select all tracks. Select the first one, hold shift and select the last one. Then hit Control and G to group them. And then hit Control and R to rename the group to all. And then we need to remove this visualizer and move it to all. And this one can be deleted. Okay, so we set up. And maybe you already noticed I'm using an external VST plugin for the visualizer. And the reason for this is the internal spectrum analyzer of Bitwig has a different weighting of the display. And to show you that, I'm using another plugin, which is called MDA Test Tone. And this test tone device can generate pink noise. It's a completely different weighting. And on this plugin, you can even choose or set up your weighting as you like without changing the sound. After we set up our visualizer to have an even line with the pink noise sound, we can use this to mix down our track visually. All we have to do is basically bring all our instrument tracks to a certain volume so that the frequency spectrum is basically an even line. And to start this organized, I usually tend to group the tracks first. So let's try this. We take the kick and our drum tracks, select them and group them together. I have a main clap here and some additional claps, and I group the additional claps together because they are not so important at the moment. Collapse and mute. What I try to do here is basically I try to reduce the tracks to my core elements of my song, so I don't have to deal with so many possibilities at the start. And the only tracks that remain are basically bass, overtones from the bass, a kick, rimshot and the clap. And the rimshot and the clap are basically one sound, because I try to have more like a snare to layer a rimshot with the clap, so we can group them together too. And now we can start to mix down our track. And as always, I start at the bottom with the bass. So let's mute this and this. And the first track is important because I'm setting the point of reference and I'm going for minus 45. And this is not a special number. It's basically the number I've chosen to going for. So this is the line, minus 45. So let's try to line up the bass, the kick drum. That's okay. The kick and the bass together are also good together. So let's going forward with the snare. And that's the first stylistic choice I make in the mixdown. I'm trying to stay with the snare below minus 45 because I don't think the snare should be that loud in my track. But it's still around minus 45, not far away. Okay. We ignore the additional claps because they are not that important at the moment, so I'm going forward with the pads. Let's bring them in. It's totally okay to stay below minus 45 with the pad sounds because longer sounds tend to sound louder in the mix than shorter sounds. And of course you can try to EQ certain hills in this diagram out, but you maybe lose of course sound character. So I'm perfectly fine with this. And I try to bring in the melody. And for me, this is okay when the melody is basically overstepping the minus 45 line, because it's the melody, it's pretty important, right? So let's try our last step, that is mixing the bass top. I think this mixdown is perfectly fine for now. It's a great starting point. Of course, it's not finished because there's so much more you can do. But in this tutorial, I just wanted to show you how you can approach a mixdown in a more organized way. You start at the bottom and setting up a reference point where you can match each other track against. And basically start at the bottom and then work your way through to the top. And this is a way of approaching a mixdown in a more organized and cleaner way. And I think it leads to better results, and it's a better starting point for adding more stylistic choices. So that's basically it for today's tutorial. This one was a pretty hard one for me to make because there's so much stuff around mastering and mixing down a track, and I just wanted to nail down the basic things. So if you learned something today, then please leave me a like, hit the subscribe button, or leave me a donation. It's always appreciated. And thanks for watching. Until next time, see you.